Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace Aleya, and today it's another Filmmaking Friday. I know I'm wearing something colorful today, but it's actually really good weather in Belgium, and trust me, that's very unique, so... But I'm sitting inside to make a tutorial for you guys, because I love you. So, in this tutorial, I will be talking about the new update that Adobe Premiere Pro released in April 2018 called audio ducking. This is an automated way to duck your audio, and ducking audio is actually having a song or audio below your interview or any kind of sound, and then once the interview or the speech comes, the music actually gets lower, and then once the speech is done, it gets louder again. So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro, see what the update contains and how to work with it. It's super awesome if you're doing long kind of interviews or tutorials like me and you want to have a nice background sound. But before we start, I want to also let you know that if you're gonna use a background song for your video, make sure that it's a very nice and interesting song with a lot of variation in that song. Because if you have a video without a song and you just talk in a video, or you have a video with a bad song below it, it's actually worse. It does more harm to your video to add a kind of painful song to listen to, and that will actually distract the audience from watching your video. But on the other hand, if you have a very nice song, it actually grabs the attention from your audience because you have more dynamic video, a more vibrant video, as it contains a little bit more layers in the audio channel. And a great place to find great music for background music, for example, is on my friend's channel called Levito Beats. He makes awesome, awesome beats, and they're completely instrumental. Well, most of his videos are instrumental beats, so that's ideal to put below a speech because you don't want a song with text. Otherwise, your audience is gonna get distracted, whether it's the lyrics or if it's actual the speech of the interview. So make sure that your song doesn't contain any words and just instrumentals. So head off to Levito Beats. All his beats are completely for free. All you have to do is kind of mention him within the video that you're making for YouTube. And if you want a royalty free, you can also go and buy it from him. But he's a great guy, and it's not because he's my friend that I like to use his music, because I have plenty of places to find music and I'm completely free in using whatever I want. But honestly, I always find what I want on his channel, so I really like the style and you might do as well. So I will put a link in the description so you can go ahead and check it out, and it's completely for free, so why not give it a try? So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro, see what the audio ducking contains. Before we continue this video, I would like to present you our website designed for filmmakers and video editors to improve their workflow. We offer templates, presets, high-quality pre-made packs, soundscapes, essential graphics, and much more. If you don't have time to create something of your own, or you just want to speed up your workflow, definitely check out our website with the link in the description below. All right, so here we have a timeline that I prepared for this video. We have some clips with audio, and it doesn't really matter if they're split up or if there's just no audio below it. It could also contain an entire video where the speech here is kind of muted, and that's completely up to you. But yeah, I didn't have a kind of silent moment within my video, so I actually had to kind of slice it up. But usually how you would go around ducking your audio is by going right over here, kind of making this layer a little bit bigger, and then clicking on a keyframe for the audio level right here, then move a little bit forward and then click on a new keyframe, move forward, click on another keyframe, and then right here and click on a keyframe. And what you would do is actually bring this down and then this down to a specific kind of decibel level. And that's a great way to do it. So you have a low volume and then it moves up because here is no kind of speech. So the audio gets on its regular level, which is pretty cool. But imagine you're doing this for a video from 2 hours long, an interview where you have a lot of variation, you have a lot of ducking to do. You're gonna spend some time here. It's gonna take you a long time. So what Premiere Pro did in the new update right here is actually completely automated this working method. So we're gonna undo everything so we have a clean audio file to work with. And what we wanna do is actually go to Window and open up the Essential Sound, which is a great new tool that is recently introduced in Adobe Premiere Pro. You can do a lot of audio tweaking within Premiere Pro, which is great. You don't have to use any external software. But what you want to do is actually select your speech, go to the loudness, so dialogue, and then loudness, and click on the auto match button right here. Then go to your song and also go to the music loudness auto match. Okay, so that's already done. You can see what that actually does to my music. And then what you want to do is click on the music, simply go to the new ducking tab right here. And now you can actually choose where to duck against. So it can either be sound effects, speech, music. It doesn't really matter. But in this case, it's actually a speech. So we're gonna select this icon right here. Then you can choose the sensitivity. That's actually how many seconds you want in between the clip to reduce the ducking, I suppose. And then we have the fades here. So I'm going to increase the fades a little bit, increase the sensitivity to like 10. And then reduce it by, let's say, 14. So once you chose your settings right here, you can simply click on generate keyframes, and automatically you will see that you created some keyframes right here within your timeline. So you can see right here that every time there is no speech, the audio actually gets louder. So it actually moves it up. So imagine this being in an actual video where the silence is actually, for example, right here. We can also do this by decreasing the sensitivity to something like 4, generate the keyframes. Just as an example, we can see right here there is no speech, and I didn't kind of cut this video clip. You can still see that right here the music gets louder because there is no speech here whatsoever. So that's basically it. You just click one button, you have audio ducking enabled. It doesn't matter if your video is 2 hours long, 5 hours long, 1 hour long, or just 1 minute long. It's just a very quick and easy way to kind of get a more dynamic tone within your video. All right, so that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel for more, and definitely check out the website toleratedcinematics.com, because we have a lot to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists, and much more. So definitely check it out, because if you buy something, it helps to support this channel. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.